Jonathan Paula presents Game Time. Hello and welcome back to another exciting arcade edition of Game Time. I am playing Asteroids. The original Asteroids. Oh, there's the fire button. Hello. Alright, why does my fire button not work? Oh, there it goes. I'm gonna really smack the thing. This is really hard if I can't fire! Oh, jeez. Alright, I'm almost dead. This is really, really difficult when you have to smash the controller just to get the thing to fire. Oh, jeez. Game over. Alright, let's try again. I don't care about my name. EAA. Awesome. I made fourth place with that. Cooperate, you piece of junk. This thing's older than I... Oh, here we go. A little better. Just needs a little bit of TLC, my friends. Oh, that was close. Let's get out of there! This game is real easy. You just gotta shoot stuff and avoid getting hit, you know? Classic arcader. One of my favorites because it's so simple. Because it's just so old. Originally released in 1979, Atari is responsible for, well, bringing monochromatic video games to the forefront of American culture. Oh, got you, you little UFO son of a bitch. Alright, I got a couple rocks left. Yes. Oh. That guy got me. That guy right there is the one that got me. Ooh, I got it. Second level. Here we go. Sound effects in this game are really, really simple, but totally, totally awesome. Oh, come on. This game is really kind of... really keeps you alert, you know? Of course, I have a hyperspace button in the original Asteroids. Some of the sequels and remakes added a shield button, which was a little bit more helpful because you didn't just randomly jump around the map. You just put shields on. Game over. All right, I have to put my initials in. Let's see if I can do that. J, B, and P. Here we go. Look at that. High score of the day. And I only played for like 5 seconds.
I'm gonna try
one more time. All right, here we go. You stupid asteroids. We have to, you know, build a colony on Mars, and you guys are in our way. So, my responsibility. I have been paid minimum wage to go out here and to shoot the asteroids in my little triangle ship. Now, fun fact about the triangle from Asteroids: this is the missing slice of Pac-Man's face. I don't know if you knew that or not. True story. They took the slice out of Pac-Man and they made him into an asteroid ship. Get out of there, you junker. All right, great. Second level. Oh, shoot. It gets really hairy once you start moving around because you drift in space. You know, there's nothing to slow you down, so it gets really hairy really, really fast. That also probably made it a lot easier for the programmers of this game to make, because they didn't have to account for physics or any of that crap. Oh geez, yeah, see, I didn't even know where I ended up there. That was too bad. Alright, J... Oh, gee, I screwed up. Let's just put JP, that'll be close enough. JP! That was third place, overall. I have one coin left. One coin for this whole trip to Funspot. Let's try to get to the third level. I'm probably not going to succeed, because this game is pretty difficult. But hey, if you're good at Asteroids, leave your top score in the comments down below and impress me, you know? Come on, you piece of junk. Oh, come on. See, it's frustrating when you have to play a game that's 32 years old. Because not always does it actually cooperate with you. I'm going to drift into that thing. Oh, get out of there! Now, if these asteroids just took their pants off, we'd have no problems at all, would we? music gets more intense when you get to the end of the level, doesn't it? Alright, here we go. One more left. Oh, I got that little bugger. Rapid fire, turbo mode. Where's my Sega Genesis Game Genie when I need it? Love Game Genie. You guys ever own a Game Genie? Those things are awesome. Pretty sure this game predates the Game Genie by a number of years, though. Oh, yeah, no, I don't think so. Turbo mode. Oh, geez, that thing came right at me. Put my brain on the back windshield of this thing. All right, here we go. We're going to get to the third level. I don't think I've ever made it to the third level before, but this is going to be it. Yes, third level. Wow, even more rocks than the last two levels. How creative. Just when I get on a roll, the controls jam up on me again. This must be what it's like for real astronauts, you know? Houston, we have a problem. My controls are jammed. I got 74-30 for my high score after just a few quick attempts. But my camera is running out of tape, and I am running out of money, so that's going to do it for this episode of Game Time. Well, thank you for watching, and thank you for listening to me suck at video games. My name is John, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.